neighbors. Everybody needs good neighbors with a little understanding. You can find the perfect blend. Neighbors should be there for one another. That's when good neighbors become good friends.
So let's go across to the Taylor house and clear the air, shall we?
No way. Kim asked me to stay out of it, and that's exactly what I'm going to do. Kim's mother is a narrow-minded old bag.
Well, she's also a very angry lady. Your headmaster warned me that things are getting a little bit more serious. Apparently, she's organised for her husband to fly back from interstate to discuss pressing carnal knowledge charges against you.
Then why did you ask her out?
I love her.
You? What?
I love Kim.
Now you're being ridiculous.
You asked for the truth. I told you the truth. Now leave me alone, okay?
Well, the point is the kids don't want to get married. They just want to go on seeing each other.
I said that. You and Anne said that. No, I'm the wrong person to ask about, Scott, because I'd say, well, if you really love each other, go to it.
Scott.
Oh, Scott,
Kim's disappeared.
Neil,
have you any idea where she might be?
No, none.
I hope you realise what you're doing to this family, young man. God knows what stupid things you've been telling Kim. If you talk her into running away tonight, you'd better say before the police get here.
I told you, I don't know where she is.
Scott, go upstairs and get dressed.
My name's Kim. She's 14 years old.
Mrs. Taylor, Scott is my son. As far as I'm concerned, he's done nothing wrong. Where's Scott?
Well, didn't he go downstairs just before?
No, he didn't.
That stupid things about us. When you and your father left yesterday, she tried to get me to a doctor again.
Why?
She thought we'd... I locked myself in my room. When I went to bed, I cleared out.
Where'd you sleep?
Under a bridge. I was too scared to come here in the dark. How'd you know I'd be here?
Your mother and father came around about midnight. I called the police. It's all crazy.
What are we gonna do, Scott?
We'll be okay. At least no one knows we'll be here.
Come on, sit up.
Oh, what's in it?
Just lemon and some aspirin. Sip it, Danny. Did you have another nightmare?
Did I yell out?
No.
I guess I didn't.
Danny. Look, this sudden illness of yours has nothing to do with that trouble you are in at school, has it?
Of course not. Well, the way Dad's going on, you'd swear the whole thing was my fault.
Oh, well, taping people without their knowledge is pretty lousy, don't you think?
It was only meant as a joke.
Oh, some joke. Like that tape you have done on your father and me? I wouldn't give him that classic if I were you.
Don't worry. Why doesn't he like me, Mum?
Who says he doesn't like you?
I do. Well, look at the way he's always bawling me out. Well, he hardly ever has a go at Shane.
Perhaps it's because Shane doesn't fight to get the last word the way you do.
Why'd you marry him?
I married him because I loved him.
Loved him? How could anyone love him?
Okay, Smarty. Out of bed and off to school. You have no more call than I have.
I have.
Out, I said.
I have!
Out!
Oh, Mum, please don't make me go to school today. Well, that Mrs. Taylor, you don't know what she's like. Well, now that Kim and Scott have run away, she'll blame me all the more.
We don't know they've run away together. All right?
Not much. Should have seen them at the old monastery.
Off to the shower.
$15.76.
Well, what do we get?
Eggs, sausages, bread.
Milk?
Yeah, milk and butter.
Want some matches?
Matches?
To cook the sausages?
Oh, yeah. I thought I'd ring Dad.
Why?
Just to let him know I'm okay. I won't tell him where we are.
Okay. You really like your father, don't you?
Sure. Don't you like yours?
Never says much. They were both almost 40 when I was born. I guess that accounts for them being so old-fashioned.
Your mother's that all right. Anyway, you stay here. I'll be back soon.
Okay.
I'll tell you what. See if you can find something to cook the sausages in. An old dish or something.
Is Mr. Robinson here?
No, he had to go to the office. Please come in.
Thank you. He obviously isn't taking this as seriously as my husband and I are.
He's taking it very seriously, Mrs. Taylor. He'll be back shortly. Won't you sit down? Would you like a cup of tea?
No, thank you. I told the police they could contact me here.
Yes, of course. I'm sure Kim's all right. If Scott's with her, he'll take care of her.
Take care of her? I hate to think what that means.
You must have noticed as his teacher how level-headed and mature he is.
Mature? I honestly can't believe you're being serious.
Excuse me. Hello?
Grandma? It's Scott.
Where are you?
It's okay. Is Dad there?
No, but he won't be long.
Is that your grandson?
Yeah. Is Kim with you?
Yeah. Can you tell her parents not to worry?
Mrs. Taylor's here. Will you talk to her?
No, Grandma. Tell Dad...
I want to know where my daughter is.
Where can your father contact you, Scott?
What the hell with contacting him? Tell him to get my daughter back home.
I'm going to hang up, Grandma.
No, Scott, don't do that. Scott, don't.
I think they're cool.
Believe me, they're still raw. Have some more milk. I felt as guilty as hell in that shop. The old guy wouldn't stop watching me. Probably thought I was going to shoot through without paying.
Did you find your father?
He was out. I spoke to Grandma. It's cool.
Did you say you were with me?
Sure, why not? I told her to tell your parents.
Oh, why'd you do that, Scott? You promised.
I promised I wouldn't tell them where we were, and I didn't. We're not little kids, Kim. What's the point of giving your mother and father all that hassle?
I'm not going back home.
We both know you'll have to.
No way!
Look, be reasonable. How are we going to survive? We've only got a couple of dollars left.
We could get a job.
Where?
Oh, in the city. There must be dozens of jobs going.
Dozens of jobs and thousands of kids going for them. Forget it.
You don't have to come with me.
I'm not going to. I'm only here because I wanted to help you take a stand with your parents. I've got no fight with my family, and I don't want to hurt them.
Oh, you just don't understand, do you? All my life, my mother's watching me like a hawk. She warns me to be careful about everyone I meet. The girls are always promiscuous and the boys are only after one thing. She called me a liar when I told her the truth about those tapes and threatened me with doctors and the police. You said your father believed you. Well, what would you have done if you carried on the way my mother did?
He isn't like that.
No, and that's why you don't understand.
How is it?
Nice. I suppose you'll be going back home then.
Will you change your mind?
No. I won't go back. I can't.
Well, I better stick with you.
Get down here! Come on! hell do you think's the matter? Your mother sent you to school.
I didn't go, did I?
Now, you listen to me, bird brain. How the hell am I supposed to run a business with cops turning up every 2 minutes asking questions about them damn runaway kids, eh?
I don't know what you're talking about, Dad. And what's it got to do with us?
That crazy teacher of yours has gone screaming to the press and television. So they're all hanging around the school waiting to interview Scott Robinson's best friend. And your headmaster phones me...
Look, I've already told the police I don't know where they went.
Well, get back to school and tell the rest of them that, eh? Oh, crikey, it's just as well your brother thought you might be down here, because if I lose any more work through this, you better start running yourself.
Yeah, well, I just might do that.
You think about it, because you don't know how close you are to being chucked out. Now, come on.
In Melbourne, they make for St Kilda. In Sydney, it's the Cross. Last year alone, more than 25,000 children and teenagers either ran away or were kicked out of their homes. This pretty young girl is Kim Taylor. Now, Kim wasn't kicked out. She ran away. And her mother is determined that Kim won't end up as just another statistic.
I'm determined to find my daughter. She left home because of a silly misunderstanding. I'll spend every day and night searching until I find her to tell her how much we love her and want her home. I'll not have become one of those pathetic creatures society has chosen to ignore for too long.
What sort of a girl is Kim?
She's a sweet girl. An innocent girl.
I understand a young boy's involved.
Yes. He followed Kim. Perhaps they planned it together, I don't know, but what I do know is that they have no money and nowhere to go. They probably think it's romantic, but so did those other 25,000 children. Once.
Why is she being so hypocritical?
Who cares? As long as she gets the press to help. 25,000 kids, that's incredible.
Yeah, but Scott's got no reason in the world to end up in one of those squats.
Kim's reason enough.
What's a squat?
Old empty houses where many of them live.
Oh.
I'll say this for Marcia Taylor, she's getting some publicity. Seems that nobody cares at all about runaway kids these days.
Hmm. I remember years ago when your Uncle Jack was about 10, and he ran away. And the police closed down the bank to help in the search.
Where'd they find him?
Hiding under the house in a packing case.
Mm-hmm.
No, I agree with Paul. Scott will take one look at the conditions they live under and he'll come home.
That's if his pride doesn't get in the way.
I know I said I'd stay with you, but we haven't got any money.
It'll only be until we get a job.
We're not going to get a job, Kim. You're going to have to face up to that.
I'll get a job. You'll see.
Look, Dad'll help us. If we both go to my place and explain.
No. Look, I told you I wouldn't go back, and that includes your place as well.
But you don't know my dad. He'd maybe give us
look,
some money.
Look, I said no, Scott. If you want to go home, just go. Remember one thing. What my mother's probably accused you of doing to me, the police will be looking for you all over the place.
But we haven't done anything.
I'm glad you went back and got those candles. It'd be real scary here without some light.
I only ran away to look after you, remember?
Great. That's great. It's all my fault now, is it?
Well, you started it, didn't you?
Oh, it was stupid Danny Ramsey with his stupid tape recorder who started it.
Suit yourself. I'm going to sleep.
Night.
Why are you crying?
I'm not crying.
Finished with that. Who's that on the phone?
Julie. She read about Scott in the papers.
Oh, yeah? What are they saying now?
Oh, Romeo and Juliet. All very romantic.
We talked her into staying until Saturday.
Yeah, we can do without Miss Bossy Boots for the moment, I think.
I'll go. Morning, Max. Danny.
Sorry about you, Jim. Can we have a word?
Yeah, sure. Come in.
Look, yous have always been good neighbours. You, Helen, the kids.
Thanks.
Well, Maria and I'd hate to do anything to upset yous, like. What I'm trying to say, we got to the bottom of what this fool done with them tape recordings, and I'm real sorry, mate.
Oh, thanks, Max.
No, hold on. Go on, say it.
I'm sorry, Mr. Robinson. Well, Scott's a good mate. I'm very sorry.
Oh, it's all right, Danny. Look, we all know it was a joke that backfired. Let's just forget about it.
Thanks.
Right, now get out. I want to talk to Mr. Robinson. Jim, the kid's been telling everyone he made that tape recording of Scott and the young girl down by the river. Well, Maria thinks he's probably lying, because this morning he slipped up and mentioned some old monastery.
Monastery?
Yeah. Does it mean anything?
No, not to me.
Paul?
Scott telephoned, you know, but he hung up before Helen could find out where he was.
Mm.
He's dead. G'day, Mr. Ramsey.
Paul.
Did Scott ever mention anything to you about an old monastery?
Scott!
Dad!
Oh, mate.
How did you know I'd be here?
We'll talk about that later, mate. Where's Kim?
She won't go back, Dad.
I see. What about you?
I want to stay with her.
What? You mean live here?
No, we're going to move on this morning.
Well, you realise you won't get very far. You two are big news at the moment. Romantic runaways. Romeo and Juliet today. Pictures are everywhere. You know Kim's mum's resigned?
From teaching?
Yes, she wants to devote herself to finding you two. It's hardly the action of an uncaring mother now, is it?
How can you defend her? You know she's wrong about Kim and me.
We all make mistakes, Scott. People are going to say I made a mistake coming here on my own. Perhaps I should have told Kim's parents or the police. Even the press. And we could have dragged you both back screaming to your homes. But you just resented us. Besides, what would be the point? Probably just take off again. We might even get to the stage we'd welcome it. There was an item on the TV about the pair of you last night. I thought about it all night. You know, 25,000 kids a year do what you two have just done. How the hell do they survive out there? And what sort of future have they got? They've ruined their education, destroyed any chance they had of happiness. I keep thinking, where will they be in 5 or 10 years' time? I feel very sorry for those kids. And their families. You know we all love you, mate.
Yes, Dad.
Well, Kim's parents obviously love her. Perhaps their problem is that they've tried too hard to avoid this very thing happening in their lives. Please come home with me.
Not unless Kim does.
Will you ask her to come and talk to me?
Okay. But if she won't, I'm going to stay with her. Kim? Kim? Dad, she's gone. Kim!
Come on, Scott, give it up.
She couldn't have cleared off so quickly.
We've been searching for over an hour. If Kim's still here, she obviously doesn't want us to find her. If she's gone, she'll be miles away by now.
Yeah, I suppose.
Come on, let's go home.
Oh. Grandma?
What on earth are you doing home?
Hi. Well, you can hardly expect me to stay away when my little brother's in trouble.
But we told you on the phone there was nothing you could do. Mm-hmm. Your father and I wanted you to enjoy your holiday.
Oh, yes, and I did enjoy it. But, you know, I think I belong here with the family.
Oh, you and your family. I bet you'd give that job up at the bank like a shot if you could stay home and look after this lot.
Actually, I wouldn't mind, you're right. When you get too old, that's exactly what I'll do.
Ah, but I'm not going to get too old. Mm. So you better stay in the bank and marry one of your wealthy customers. Mm.
That's a listen. Tell us what happened with Scott and that girl.
Have you had any breakfast?
No, actually, I haven't. I left about 6.
Well, come on, I'll get you some and we'll talk.
Right. Scott! Oh, hello. Give us a snuggle.
I thought you were on holidays.
Well, I was, but I was worried about you. Oh, hey, isn't this great?
Hello, Grandma.
Hello, love.
Oh, he needs a bath. Scott, you need a bath.
Off you go, mate.
Yeah, thanks.
Hi, Di.
Hi.
How did you find them?
I didn't find them, I only found him. I'll have to go up and see the tailors. See you later.
Neighbours, everybody needs good neighbours. Just a friendly wave each morning helps to make a better day. Get to know each other. Next door is only a footstep away. Neighbors, everybody needs good neighbors with a little understanding. You can find the perfect blend. Another. That's when good neighbors become